Hi, my name is Paul Vrosi, and my research is on the advantage of a novel gate set for noisy intermediate scale quantum computers. While the effectiveness of quantum computing hardware has skyrocketed in recent times, with the quantum advantage experiment by the Google Group being a large milestone, all quantum computers still have a lot of unwanted interaction with the environment. Additionally, many of the common gates used in current quantum algorithms are partial two-qubit gates, which require additional overhead to perform. With careful hardware-level optimization, these gates can be performed without overhead and will often show a reduced error rate based on the fraction of the full two-qubit gate. This concept is called error-divisible gates, or EDG. To demonstrate the effectiveness of EDG, we perform variational quantum eigensolver, or VQE, calculations for the anti-ferromagnetic, AFM, Heisenberg model of spins. VQE has been extremely bountiful at finding approximate ground state energies of many Hamiltonians, even in the presence of noise. This algorithm works by layering parameterized gates on the qubits and measuring the expectation value of the Hamiltonian at the end. This expectation value is then used as the cost function for a classical optimizer, which adjusts the parameters to minimize the ground state energy. The model we are studying, the AFM Heisenberg model, while solved analytically in one dimension, is still interesting in higher dimensions and serves as a good benchmark model. We then compare three regimes of gate sets for VQE calculations from 4 to 10 qubits. The results clearly demonstrate the ability of EDG to reach higher percentages of the true ground state energy for all system sizes. For the stock gate set and continuous gate set, where errors do not decrease with smaller partial rotations, they're unable to reach nearly as high of a percentage. Additionally, with EDG, the optimal circuit depth is much deeper, indicating an ability for EDG to perform potentially longer algorithms. In the future, it will be interesting to get these types of gates implemented on physical hardware, as well as better understand what the maximum error rate can be to still achieve good results from VQE using EDG. Thank you.